you can do any transaction you want, right? So Steam blockchain right now, if you check blocktivity.info, you will notice that the Steam blockchain actually controls about 60% of the entire crypto transaction worldwide. See, 60% of the transaction of cryptocurrency transaction worldwide is on the Steam blockchain. Right, so Steam blockchain it's actually a plus to the crypto space generally.
Okay, thank you so much once again, Sam. Over to you, Mr. Joshua.
Yeah.
Okay, what has made Steam blockchain successful so far? From what I've heard from him, he said it's the fastest growing blockchain.
True.
So what has made it different or successful than the rest?
Okay, number one thing I think is responsible for the massive growth of Steam blockchain is the application of Steam to this thing, to content creation. The fact that Steam is the DP blockchain and built it in such a way that you can actually create content and then earn from the content that you are creating, you understand? And you can also curate someone else's content, engage in someone else's content, and you get paid for it. I think that's one of the reasons why Steam has really grown. And then the second one is the seamlessness of the transactions on the Steam blockchain. It's fast, it's easy, and there are no transaction fees. So I think if you're transferring Bitcoin to someone, they charge you, and then it takes time. And the amount of energy Bitcoin consumes from what happened really, it takes a lot. But on the Steam blockchain, it's easier, it's faster, it's cheaper. You understand? Yes, so I think those are the two major factors driving the ease or the massive growth of the Steam.
Okay, so thank you, Mr. Joshua Attard. You mentioned Steemit, and all of us here are on Steemit. If you were not on Steemit, you probably might not be here. So to further explain to us what Steemit is, some sticks used to disturb me. It used to disturb me a lot sometime last year about Steemit till I finally made it into the community. So Sam Six, could you tell us what Steemit is? Give us a brief. What is Steemit?
Alright, thank you, your mom. Okay. Now Steemit is a social media, right? That is used on Steam blockchain. Right? It's like having a paid version of Facebook.
Okay.
See, I remember the first time I heard about Steemit was in 2016, and although when I heard about Steemit the first time, I didn't believe. I was like, you mean Steemit would pay me to do what I'm already doing on Facebook? If that was possible, do you know how Facebook would have been doing it already? So because of that thought, I just didn't register until the next day. So Steemit is like having a version of Facebook that rewards you for your valuable content. You see, like Facebook doesn't charge you. You don't pay to use Facebook. Well, how do they make their money? From you. So the more you post stuff about yourself, about politics, about music, about whatever you're doing, the more valuable Facebook becomes. Steemit is actually the opposite of Facebook, or the better version of Facebook. Yes. The more value you add to Steemit, the more reward you get. So it's like having Facebook pay you for the valuable content you put. So that was Steemit. So it's a social network, right? That rewards your valuable content that are originally yours.
Okay, wow, that's beautiful. Thank you, Sam Six, for that wonderful talk about Steemit. Like I said earlier, all of us here on the show are Steemians. We joined Steemit at one point or the other, and we'll briefly share our Steemit experiences. I'll share mine. Okay, I said earlier that Sam Six, sometime in March 2017, telling me to bring my content to Steemit. I used to write a lot on Facebook. If you check my Facebook page now, I don't really have so much. I used to write a lot on Facebook and meaningful things, and I had good audience. And he has been telling me, Bree, why not come to Steam Week? I was angry. I didn't believe until I finished school in July and I was really, really broke. And my friend, my other friend, Ifyo, reminded me about joining Steam Week, and I was like, okay, let's give it a try. So I joined Steam Week November last year. And my first week on Steam Week wasn't encouraging, but my second week became better. I started understanding the platform. I met people, I attended meetups. I met people I used to see online. I met them offline. And it was beautiful. Ending was very interesting. I think towards December, one Steam dollar was about 4,000 naira. Making a post and earning that much was beautiful. So my Steam Week experience has been full of ups and downs, but I love Steam Week. Thank you very much. So, Joshua Attard, tell us about your Steam Week experience.
Okay, I joined finally after some sticks brought HMI and Juju Kaka to here. I think we talked about Steam Week, they explained a little bit more, they talked about start and stuff. So I was like, okay, fine, I think I'm actually done with this. My Steammate journey, I think over time, I decided to do something on Steammate, and that's Bank of Attack. It's a cryptocurrency bank with same Steam, USDT, and 15% interest on the coins. Actually, why I started that was because I'm an entrepreneur. Apart from the programming stuff, I did some other basic stuff online, offline sales. So I needed money at a point in time, but I didn't have it. So I was like, okay, what if I build a structure, a system where I can actually borrow money from a large pool of people and pay them back with interest in an organized form rather than just chatting somebody up or calling someone to ask a person for money. So I started talking to people, and I started on WhatsApp with my Steam contacts. People told me that people thought I was joking, and well, basically we've grown. It has actually grown massively, more than I expected. I think last week, a couple of weeks ago, someone saved over 700. Yeah, so we've grown massively, and I finally registered in CSC because I'm actually trying to bring it offline and do something big time out of it. I want to use it to drive more awareness for cryptocurrency. So I really want to see Steam Week as being a blessing.
Okay, so it was beautiful listening to your Steam Week experience. Over to Prof Chidon, the developer. What have you developed? Courtesy Steam Week. Talk to us about your Steam Week experience.
Okay, that's a nice question. We all know about Steam Week and been in, on this platform for some time. I think I was also introduced to Steam Week by Sam Steam. We call him the general overseer of Steam Week in New York and in Nigeria. I joined Steam Week in 2017, June, yeah, he introduced me, and I wasn't serious with it. I left Steam Week because I wasn't making enough, and in 2018, earlier this year, when I was done with my studies, I decided to have a look at it, and I came back. And coming back, I noticed Steam Week is just about your unique content. So when I went in, I was trying hard to post and all that, but at a later time I discovered a platform that suited my talent and my skills, which was Utopian.io. So presently or currently I post, I'm a developer and I do all my stuff on Utopian.io, and I am also working on a project called SteamAxe. If you go to my blog at Prof Chidon, you see SteamAxe. SteamAxe is a decentralized app used on the Steam blockchain that gives Steam users, not even just Steam users, both Steamians and non-Steamians, the opportunity to ask questions and get answers. So when you ask questions, and if someone knows about your question, or if your question is valuable enough, they upvote and all that. And when someone gives,
it's like Quora,
a decentralized version of Quora. So it's ongoing, and very soon I'll launch the alpha version for testing and all that. So far, I've found myself on Steam, and it didn't take me much time, though it did actually, but it didn't take me much time to find myself. And I am so thankful that I did. And I would encourage everyone who is not on Steemit to log on to www.steemit.com and sign up and enjoy the stuff we do. Thank you.
Wow. Okay, so over to you, my very lovely friend, Kristen Antai. Tell us about your Steemit experience. I know it got sour for you at the point, but just tell us, how has it been?
Okay, thank you very much, Dio Bong. Yeah, I had a bad experience at a point in Steemit, which I wanted giving up, but thank God I didn't, because I would have been regretting by now. I got to know of Steemit. Okay, I just woke up one morning and went on WhatsApp. One of my colleagues just told me, have you heard of Steemit? That was what she just dropped, Steemit.com, and I was like, what is Steemit.com? She didn't come online, you know, till I just went and registered. I thought it was a Ponzi scheme, because I loved that. That was back then. I just went, sign up, and then I didn't know of password and everything. I just signed up. I didn't see, you know, like now that they'll tell you, copy and save your password. I didn't see anything. I just clicked save in my Chrome, and that was it. So at a point, that was December 22nd, I registered, but I didn't start blocking till Prof Chidon opened a group chat on WhatsApp and started telling us about Steemit. So I just decided to try, start blocking, and also at a point also, I wanted to start using my laptop to log in. So I didn't know that you can't get your password, which I didn't save back on Steemit. So that was a problem. I then went to generate password. I didn't know if I don't have the old password, I won't be able to get a new password. So that was where the mistake started from. I lost, I misplaced the password, which I didn't save actually. Everything was gone. I had to start afresh again, open another account by March, and then start over again. And here I am. Steemit so far has been a very wonderful experience to me. It has helped me a lot. I never knew I'll come this far on Steemit, but thank God I met this wonderful community, Steemjets. I'm very grateful right now, and I'll be forever grateful to Dimim for the opportunity to be among the talented individuals he has set aside to work for him. Thank you so much for everything.
Okay, so that was quite an experience. Good and bad, and she didn't give up. Like, if I was the one, I don't know, but I wouldn't have given up anyways. Steemit could be very addictive. So to the guy who is responsible for all of us being on the Steem blockchain, it might have taken longer for me, if not for him. So Samson, tell us about your Steemit experience briefly.
Okay, when I said Steemit, it was really rough. Like, the first 6 months wasn't smooth at all. But you see, it actually came for the community and not the rewards. Even though the rewards was like a motivation to use the platform, right? So when I started Steemit and I was getting those little rewards, I said to myself, despite the fact that these rewards are small, they could actually add value to someone else's life. So I decided to start teaching people for free, and I opened a WhatsApp group, and today we are quite a huge number, and Steemit so far has been a blessing to a lot of people in our community. And right now, at the stage that we are right now, I want to say a big thank you to Dean, that's his name. I'm sure he's going to watch this video, and I'm really grateful for what you've been doing for our community, you know, for reaching out to these guys, to us, you know, and trying to change the world through us. Thanks for believing in our community. Thanks for believing in us. And thank you.
All right, thank you so much, our boss, Steemit. He came for the community. Community on Steemit is massive. It's great. There are several communities on Steemit, but there's this one community that has been a lot to us, and that's Steemjet community. Steemjet is, I cannot explain in words, but a lot of people that have been blessed via the Steemjet community can testify, can say good things about the community. Basically, Steemjet is just to enable people know about the STEAM blockchain. That is what the STEAM Dev community is all about, global STEAM adoption. And they bring out the best in STEAMians. Like Prochidon said, that you need to find your unique niche, stick to it, get better at it, and you get rewarded for it. So STEAMJet is bringing out the superstar in every STEAMian. So we want you to be a part of the STEAMJet community. When you get on STEAMIT, if you're on STEAMIT, click on the STEAMJet tab. You see a lot of things about the community. If you're not on STEAMIT, sign up at STEAMIT.com. Join us on the STEAMJet community, and we have a lot in store for you. Thank you for joining us on today's show. Thank you, Christian Antai, my beautiful friend. Thank you, Sam Sticks. Thank you, Joshua Atta. Thank you, Prof. Jidon. I remain Veronica Edet, Beobomb on our platforms. This wonderful episode, this wonderful show was brought to you by STEAMJet Media. As you can see, I will be bringing other beautiful, beautiful episodes of cryptocurrency and blockchain talks. Stay tuned until we come your way next time. Bye.
STEAMJet on the wings of superstars. We are worlds and STEAM. Thank you.